There are hundreds of different ethnicities in the world, and as countries, cities, and towns have developed, we now see incredibly diverse communities across the globe. This, of course, has meant that the ethnic makeup of families and communities has also evolved. No longer is it unusual to see couples with roots stretching from different sides of the planet. Yet, over the centuries, cultural barriers have influenced the freedom to love. One of the most significant love stories to have captured the world's affection is that of Soretse Karma, chief of the Bamangwatu tribe, and his English bride, Ruth Williams. They had to marry in secret, sparking a furore among both the tribal elders of the chieftainship and the apartheid government of South Africa. Britain's government, then heavily in debt from World War II, could not afford to lose cheap South African gold. As a consequence, the British government began a parliamentary inquiry into Karma's fitness for the chieftainship. It was many years before the couple was allowed to live in Africa, and several more before Karma became president of what is now known as Botswana. During his presidency, Soretse Karma promoted democracy and the importance of cultural diversity. Over the years, racial tension has culminated in countless conflicts. London has been center stage to important events that changed the social and economic fabric of this country forever. Yet, despite the incredible growth, the riches that have come from the colonies and the tremendous hard-working contributions made by immigrants, their presence prompted complaints. Many were met with hostility and prejudice. Considering that it was Britain who sourced workers in 1948 to come and rebuild the mother country after World War II, racial tension was growing to the point that immigrants, as today, were blamed for unemployment and the growing running costs of the NHS. The National Front's Keep Britain White campaign became popular to the point that open demonstrations demonised anyone who looked foreign. The 1970s and 80s saw unsettling cornerstones of racial history when important demonstrations took place. Out of the hate preached by neo-Nazis came one of the biggest collective movements ever. British musicians, politicians, and creative people of all races came together to create a campaign to say no to xenophobia. The weapon they used was what everyone loved universally, regardless of race: music. People fall in love regardless of cultural and religious barriers, truly attesting that love can conquer all. Countless biracial marriages are celebrated every day around the world. My parents met in London in the early 70s. There were nowhere near the numbers of mixed-race couples back then. Certainly nothing like what we see today. Maybe it would have been easier for them to have found partners from their own backgrounds. But love doesn't work like that. It's something I know all too well myself, as my two daughters have roots in Jamaica, South Africa, Czech Republic, Ireland, and of course, England. And that kind of diversity is pretty normal in many of our friends' young families too. British national identity has been thoroughly reconstructed in an incredibly short time and is ever evolving. Today, to be British is many things. And where you'll find the most examples of this is London, one of the most cosmopolitan capital cities in the world, with over 300 languages spoken. Now, more than ever, is a time to respect and value the vast diversity of the UK and the positivity it brings. It can be wonderful when two cultures are joined together in love. In fact, it often is. It broadens our horizons and engenders more inclusivity. But of course, this doesn't always happen without problems. However, history tells us that love can defeat prejudice. And that's something we should be very proud of when we're reflecting on history to show us how far we've come.